Jane, I want to ask about that stretch there where you had the back-to-back fast break layups and just kind of how much that kind of helped turn the game.
I feel like that gave us a lot of momentum, you know, that we needed just to going into half, you know, trying to get that breakaway, you know, lead and stuff and just keep our foot on the Knicks for sure. So that helped a lot.
Ray J, you and the guy next to you combined to go 9 for 9 in the second half. Was there like a concerted effort to like go to the basket? Because a lot of y'all's buckets were drives.
Yeah, first I just want to thank my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, for allowing us to play the game we love. And then, I mean, as far as second half, I think we found something as far as like playing fast and playing in transition. And so that was kind of a focus. And like, we get stops, let's run because we're tough getting downhill.
What did y'all think of Eves, like Dominique type, when he went in the approach? Was that, did that kind of blow your mind a little bit?
Yeah, he shocked me like every day. Like, he do something new to just shock me. Like, so it just showed me how comfortable he's getting, you know, playing game in and game out for sure.
Ray J, you were pretty impressed.
Yeah,
with
that was crazy. I never seen anything like that before.
Ray J, Bill Self mentioned those 8 to 10 foot floaters that you were hitting. Is that always come easy to you, or is that one of those where you practice that a lot? And if you do, how much?
Yeah, I mean, that's something I practice every day. And being the smallest guy on the floor, you got to find a way to get shots off without getting all the way to the rim. So it's honestly a shot that I've been shooting almost as long as I've been playing basketball.
And Ray J, it seemed like a 180-degree improvement from you all from the game in Lawrence to today in terms of pick-and-roll offense. What went well when KU put two guys on the ball that allowed you all to score so effectively?
Yeah, I mean, Eve was really dangerous all day at the like at that mid spot, that high post area, and we were hitting him on the short roll. And I mean, he's super talented and just go make a play.
Jaden, just how sweet was this one in terms of, you know, anytime you play a team a second time that beats you, I mean, you want to get them back?
At first, it's just a blessing, you know, to play KU. You know, I feel like God just, you know, he blessed us to just play great teams. So, you know, it's a blessing, you know, growing up just watching them. But, you know, it's a great game just to play, you know, like that stuff. So I feel like just a great rivalry as well, you know. Coach Drew always talked to us about, you know, how important this game means to us. So, yeah, take it very seriously.
Ray J, we're actually in March now. So what is it? How important is it for games like this to give you something to build on going into, as we've gone the last week of the regular season into the postseason?
Yeah, I mean, throughout March, that's when you want to be playing your best ball. So, I mean, all these games, finishing out the regular season into the Big 12 tournament are important all the way into the NCAA tournament.
Ray J, back here behind the cameras to the left. First double-double since that triple overtime game against TCU for you. What do you think was working, I guess, distributing the ball, but not only that, scoring as well?
We got a ton of talented scorers, so I give them the ball and they hit shots. I mean, it's a testament to how hard they work.
Either one of you, I was told that Coach Drew had an impassioned speech yesterday about March Madness, preparing for it. What was that like? What was the main message that you both or either one of you got out of it?
Really just, you know, in March, you know, the whole world is watching, you know, college basketball. So just how serious to take it, but just to take it one game at a time. And, you know, just to play as hard as you can so that when, in the future, you won't look back and like, you know, I should have did this or I should have did that. Just go out there and do it and compete.
Yeah, I mean, it was just the intensity of it and saying how blessed we are to be able to play in March and we'll have a chance to play an NCAA tournament and don't leave any stone unturned.
Ray J, Scott called a timeout about 2.5 minutes into that second half. They had gone on a 6-0 run. Any kind of message there they had hit? I mean, I think they wound up hitting their first 4 or 5 shots.
Yeah, I mean, that just comes down. We got to get stops and rebounds, especially at the end of games when teams are down. We know they're going to rebound really hard. So we just had to get stops and rebounds. That's mainly what the timeout was about.
Your steal, breakaway and one layup. You had a couple trailers there. You probably knew that, but were you thinking it's all me here? Or?
I mean, I got the steal and was looking ahead, and I mean, I knew it was guys behind me, but I also know that the rest of KU was coming behind me too. So I mean, it was just me and DeJuan 1-on-1. So I took the challenge.
Well, another great game for Big 12. got a great platform God's given us, and we got a great group of guys that really like one another. They play hard for one another. They're really fun to coach. And you love to see we got four new starters this year, and you love to see as the year's gone on just the confidence grow and how they've encouraged one another. And because of that confidence and chemistry, starting to obviously reach new heights. I mean, Ray J with 19 and 10, almost a double-double for Jacoby with 8 rebounds. Jaden Nunn, 7 for 8. Eve, I mean, compare our first game of the year to now, just how much more poised he is. Josh, I mean, those guys, Jalen didn't shoot it as well, but 3 steals. And you shoot 56% against Kansas, you're really doing something well because Coach Self's teams are really good.
Scott, obviously a pretty tight game. Talk about that run, though, in the second half that Nunn kind of got started with the 2 breakaways and just kind of the change in what you guys did momentum-wise there.
Well, I think the key was to get a couple stops. And once we got a couple stops and we were able to push it in transition, and 15 fast break points to 7 was huge for us, especially the first time we played. We had 21 turnovers, let them get way too much in transition. Today, only 11 turnovers is much more what Baylor basketball is about and how we operate.
Ray J and Jaden combined to go 9 for 9 in the second half.
That's pretty good, isn't it?
That is pretty good. What was working for those dudes? Yeah.
Well, I think the first thing is they were getting good shots. And second of all, after you get good looks, I think the crowd gave us a great lift, great momentum. And it's a game of runs. It's a game of momentum. And that's why you have to have a great home crowd, because when you need a push, they're there to push you. And when things are going well, they're able to keep and sustain it. I thought we started the second half, first 2-3 minutes, not as intense as we were in the first half. And then we came out of that timeout and for the rest of the half really competed.
Coach in the back, getting a win like this against a ranked team, top 10 win, with the regular season ending just around the corner, how big of a boost was this for you and the team?
Well, first of all, every game's a big game. And right now, us in Kansas, we're tied for 3rd place, and we know the importance of where you finish for Big 12 tournament seeding. At the same time, you want to play your best basketball at the end of the year. And I like where we're trending. We got to get Langston back and get him in the mix. And once we do that, then I think we'll be in position to put our best foot forward come NCAA tournament time.
Coach, you kind of touched on it at the beginning, but just talk about E's performance.
You dressed for the whiteout. I like that.
Yes, I came prepared. But talk about E's performance. You said from the beginning to now, I mean, he took control of the game today. Talk about what you saw from him.
Well, I think early in the year, for a guy that's only played 2.5-3 years of basketball, a little unsure, a little tentative. And at the same time, our coaching staff, Coach Brooks, Coach Peterson do a lot of work with the big men, and he's a sponge. He just really learns at a quick rate, and the things that he's doing now, he wasn't doing 3 weeks ago. And if we can keep him on that trajectory, again, we should see the best in the next couple weeks.
Does Ray J just get really calm, Scott, like late in games? I mean, it's kind of great to have a finisher. He had the 1 turnover, but other than that, all the big shots. Yeah. Is it kind of a slow heartbeat kind of thing that comes in?
Well, I think Ray J's always been a great leader, and day one he got here, he was a great leader. But, I mean, first time going through the Big 12 for Ray J, Nunn, Jacoby, Eve, I mean, that's a big step up from wherever they were before, high school, college, just because it is the best league in the country, and the physicality, the length, the intensity, the 1 possessions. And with that, at the same time, the more you do it, the more confidence you get, and the more secure you are in your role, because every team you go on, it's a different situation. The one thing that's been common since day one is he's a great leader, and the teammates really all like one another, so they all encourage one another, and nobody minds deferring for another player because of the respect they have for each other. We got some other guys that really thought that they had a great float game, but we prefer getting to the rim. So, but his float game is really nice.
Scott, did y'all change anything defensively in the second half? They weren't getting as many close shots, it seemed like.
Well, we were trying to get them down from 75% to 60%. So, I mean, we mixed up defenses a little bit. I think at the end of the day, Hunter Dickerson's is a big man. Kevin McCullough, 20 points, 5 rebounds, and somebody that obviously affects the game both ends of the court. And I mean, I thought our guys did a great job on a short prep because we didn't know he was going to play.
And Scott, really great performance. Thank you. Good seeing you, Scott. Really good performance in the pick-and-roll offense today, especially compared to the game in Lawrence. How were you all able to be so effective when KU would put 2 on the ball today and improve your offense?
I think we learned a lesson up there. So as a staff, we need to do a better job preparing our guys for that, and I think we have.
Scott, ultimately it counts as 2 points, but when you start the game with a dunk like Eve had, what kind of a boost does that give your team?
Well, I know it fired Eve up, and obviously got the crowd going. And Eve's somebody that is capable of being on SportsCenter each and every night. So we see a lot of it, and it's great when everyone else gets to see it. But you have a great crowd. The worst thing you can do is do what we did against Houston and get down double digits and take them out. I mean, we want to get them involved for the whole 40 minutes, and credit our crowd even with Houston not allowing us to make a run and encouraging us to get back into it.
Scott, your starters playing big minutes and have been for a while now. Is it just as simple as trying to get Langston back into the flow, or how is that going to look going forward into March in these tougher games?
Well, I think I've noticed in college basketball that there's a lot of teams that are having a shorter rotation, and I don't know if that's because of the portal, NIL, just being able to have guys that have been in your program 2 or 3 years have experience come in and play and whatnot. But we had great minutes from, I mean, Miro was +7. Caleb did a great job in his 2 minutes. So those are important. We just haven't been in foul trouble, so that affects some of it. But I think we got guys ready to compete, but the 6 that have been playing really are in a good rhythm right now. And I don't know if you could do that from start to end of the season, but this time of year you can.
Scott, another quick turnaround. Excuse me, another quick turnaround with Texas coming into town. Last chance you guys have to play them as Big 12 opponents. Kind of, what does that matchup mean for your team, and how important is that game?
Well, it means a lot for our fans and for Baylor University. So that means a lot for Baylor and our players. So it's also senior night, and nowadays senior nights are a lot bigger than they used to be. As a coach, you're always nervous about anything that's different. It's a great opportunity, a great platform. God's given us Big Monday, so we get to show who hadn't seen Baylor the new Foster Pavilion.
And Scott, it's obviously a long drive on I-35 between you and Kansas, but with the success the two programs have had, does this really start to feel like a rivalry between you all now?
I think I know when we've gone up there, their fans have a great deal of respect for Baylor basketball, and I appreciate that. And it means that our players and program have done a great job. And I know our fans respect Kansas. And why we're the best conference in the country is because top to bottom, we're good. And there's no off night. There's nobody that's a gimme or hurts the conference. But all that, I think, is possible, too, because of Kansas' dominance since the conference was formed. And everybody chasing them is allowed everybody to kind of rise. And in the last, 4 or 5 years, we're the 2 winningest Power 5 programs, the only 2 out of 4 teams to win a first-round game or at least 1 NCAA tournament game. I mean, you can go up and down the numbers, be top 3 seed the last 4 years. I mean, it's endless, but that iron sharpens iron, and I know we get better playing great teams and great coaches.
Thank you, guys. You have a great afternoon.